2, Bangor. From the Great North Woods to the Rockbound Coast and streaming live in HD worldwide at foxbangor.com, more people choose Good Morning Maine.
Today on Good Morning Maine, a man accused of robbing a bank in Bangor pleads guilty and is sentenced to prison.
Plus, a special celebration in Bangor for an organization that takes care of police officers and their families.
And a local school district is embracing electric-powered buses to transport students to school. Good morning and welcome to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith.
And I'm Craig Colson. Thank you for tuning in today. The big story today, of course, is the winter storm that's moving into the area. We're expecting several inches of snow here in the Bangor region, perhaps as much as 10 inches by the time it's all done. Schools are getting out early for the day. A lot of them are having early dismissals. The state has closed all state offices. You know, the typical kind of stuff we do on a day like today. Just take precautions, stay inside, and stay off the roads, I guess.
I know. Sounds like the only way to go. Here's Devin Biggs with the forecast.
And thank you very much, Craig and Emma. Happy Tuesday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Crosby Sports Shop. With a large supply of ammo in stock, custom Damascus knives, fishing supplies of all kinds, concealed weapons classes, and a full line of Dragonfly UV tackle, plus the latest in ultraviolet tackle. Call today. All right, let's get things rolling out there this morning. We have weather alerts in effect. This right here is a winter storm warning in effect, and also a winter weather advisory posted. It's all toward the north. Both of these will last until Wednesday morning at about 8 a.m. as we'll be watching for accumulating snow across the region. On top of that, some strong winds that will cause the ocean to really get active at times, which is why we have gale warnings and storm warnings also posted. Some of these expiring at 1 a.m. Wednesday, others expiring later at 8 p.m. as we head towards your Wednesday as well. So we'll need to be careful with that as it does develop. We're watching it moving in from the west, going toward the east very slowly. A nor'easter on the way, though. That'll bring us some significant snow to a few spots, along with winds up to 40 miles per hour, if not worse than a few spots. We'll zoom things out. Here's the system right now, slowly tracking off towards the north and east. It's going to kind of move around for a bit before it starts to move away from us as we do proceed forward. So future cast for today, the system starts moving during the afternoon period. There's a snow right there. But again, starting to back off a little bit as we get towards Wednesday morning. That snow will continue from time to time as well. Your hourly forecast moving forward. Here we are. We're watching for the snow moving in during the afternoon period. Temperatures in the 30s. Your full five-day forecast is coming up. Craig and Emma.
All right. Thank you, Devin. A Bangor man will spend 5 years in prison for robbing a local bank. 32-year-old Donovan Steen pleaded guilty to robbery and theft for holding up the Broadway branch of Bangor Savings Bank in 2022. He made off with an undisclosed amount of cash. Steen had previously served time for holding up the Penobscot County Federal Credit Union back in 2011. The judge sentenced Steen to 10 years behind bars, with five of it suspended.
That's in large part due to his own taking responsibility. This could have dragged out a lot longer. Instead, he came in and wanted to acknowledge what he had done at the first available opportunity, and that's what he did today. So he gets some credit for that.
Steen's mother told prosecutors her son was battling drug addiction and needed the money to buy drugs. He will serve 3 years of probation once he's released from prison.
A Baltimore man who's been living in Maine is being held in Penobscot County Jail following a shooting in Bangor. 40-year-old Tyrion Kindred appeared in Penobscot County Court virtually on Monday following an incident over the weekend. Police say at about 5:30 p.m. on Saturday, Bangor police officers were called to an address on Harlow Street for a report of a person who had been shot. One adult was taken to a local hospital for treatment. Kindred has been charged with possession of a firearm by a felon. No plea was entered, but bail was set at $5,000 cash. The case remains under active investigation. It is unclear when he will be back in court.
The Piscataquis County Sheriff's Office is searching for a Guilford woman who went missing almost 2 weeks ago. Rebecca Clark left her house on Friday, March 3rd, to go to visit friends in the Boston area. She was supposed to have returned just 2 days later on Sunday, March 5th. But she did not make it back as planned, and her family has had no contact with her. She was driving a gray 2019 Hyundai Kona with Maine breast cancer plates. Anyone with information is asked to call the Piscataquis County Sheriff's Office.
Two people are credited with saving the lives of two men who fell through ice over the weekend in central Maine. On Saturday, on Pleasant Pond in Litchfield, firefighters say the men were on an ATV when they broke through the ice on Pleasant Pond in Litchfield. Another passerby saw it happen and ran to help them, but he also fell through the ice. Firefighters say two other witnesses scrambled to help and managed to get everyone out. All three men were extremely cold, but otherwise okay. A wrecker was called to retrieve the ATV from the water.
Secretary of State Shenna Bellows presented an award to the Bangor Police Relief Association to celebrate the organization's century milestone. Matthew Jaroncic has a story.
Former and current police officers gathered inside Bangor's police station lobby to commemorate the Bangor Police Relief Association being around for 100 years.
I certify that the following corporation, the Bangor Police Relief Association, has been duly incorporated as a corporation for 100 years.
This was a wonderful opportunity to celebrate the Bangor Police Department and the Bangor Police Relief Association and the work that they do.
Keynote speakers included Bellows and retired Deputy Police Chief and Association Board Member Robert Welch. The Bangor Police Relief Association was established after the Bangor Police Department was created in 1889. Its mission is to provide support for families of current and former police officers, a true testament to their fraternity. Keith Larby, a current patrol officer at Bangor Police and vice president of the Bangor Police Relief Organization, says the award speaks volumes to how officers care about one another.
It kind of bridges that gap between our retired officers and our current officers. It's very interesting to hear their perspective on what things were like, doing police work in the late 60s, 70s, 80s, and they kind of listen to my perspective on the types of things that we deal with now.
Chip Hodges, a former Bangor policeman of 32 years, says he's thankful to be part of such a tight-knit group.
It was a real honor to just be part of this this whole organization, and it becomes a big family. You've got your own family, then you've got your police family, and it really was an enlightening experience and a career that I enjoyed.
In Bangor, Matthew Jaroncic, reporting for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
The Maine Lobstermen's Association and four other organizations that represent the lobster industry filed a federal defamation lawsuit yesterday against Monterey Bay Aquarium. The lawsuit accuses Monterey Bay Aquarium of making false and defamatory statements about the state's lobster fishing practices. The lawsuit comes after Monterey Bay Aquarium's Seafood Watch program red-listed Maine lobster. The listing instructs consumers and businesses to avoid Maine-caught lobsters, claiming that lobster gear poses a threat to the endangered North Atlantic right whale. The Maine Lobstermen's Association argues the aquarium's claims are not supported by science and have caused substantial economic harm to the industry, the Maine lobster brand, and Maine's long-standing tradition of protecting the coastal environment and preserving resources for the future.
This defamation against Maine lobsters and Maine lobstermen, which affect individual families' ability to earn a living, has to be rebutted with the truth. And false statements can't be allowed to stand.
Attorney Kevin Lipson says the plaintiffs are asking for monetary relief and for Monterey Bay Aquarium to remove Maine lobster from its red list.
Democratic Representative Charles Scold of Portland introduced legislation that aims to make voting more accessible. The amendment LD 812 would require municipalities with more than 7,000 residents to provide an opportunity for in-person absentee voting on the Saturday prior to Election Day. It would also double the window for processing absentee ballots from 7 to 14 days and give the public more time to request an absentee ballot inspection prior to the clerk processing ballots. Representative Scold said in a statement, quote, "This bill would improve voter access by giving working Mainers an opportunity to vote on the weekend. People who work regular business hours Monday through Friday would have an opportunity to cast their ballot in person at their local town hall. No need to miss work, no need to fill out an application beforehand. Just show up on Saturday to your town hall and cast your vote." This bill is supported by the League of Women Voters, the Center for Secure and Modern Elections, and Maine Conservation Voters, among others. The legislature's Veterans and Legal Affairs Committee will hold a work session on that bill in the coming weeks.
All right. Well, the time is now 8:09. Coming up next on Good Morning Maine, a bill has been introduced that could change where and when people can legally consume cannabis products in Maine.
But first, another check of that forecast. We can expect snow developing as the day rolls along today. The highs will be up near 35 degrees. More blowing snow tonight with lows in right around 30. Tomorrow, the snow will continue in the morning before finally ending. The highs tomorrow right around 37.
Comfy, cozy, relaxing. Not Joe. Joe's Furniture. Joe's Furniture Warehouse in Newport is the place to find rockers, recliners, sofas, and easy chairs. Quality furniture, affordable prices. Not your average Joe. Joe's Furniture Warehouse, Grogan Avenue in Newport.
Silver Fox Automotive is a family-owned and operated company with more than 30 years of experience. We are originally from the county and offer competitive prices and promise you will be completely satisfied with our work. We offer a stress-free experience to both our new and returning customers. We only use parts from reputable brands to ensure your vehicle is safe to drive. Here at Silver Fox, there will always be a friendly face to greet you. Come see us at 2004 Audlin Road in Herman.
Autumn of Life Home Care is a great place to work. The team here provided me with all the opportunities and experience necessary to grow within the company, all while working around my busy college schedule. They provided all the necessary licensing and training. It truly was the job that kickstarted my career.
Autumn of Life Home Care in Brewer is a licensed agency with personal support specialists.
Let our compassionate, reliable, considerate caregivers make your life a little easier by providing assistance for you or your loved one.
Autumn of Life Home Care, we focus on you. Apply today.
Durable, sturdy, stylish. Not Joe. Joe's Furniture. Joe's Furniture Warehouse in Newport is the place to find solid wood, built to last, made in Maine dressers, bureaus, and nightstands. Not your average Joe. Joe's Furniture Warehouse, Grogan Avenue in Newport.
On the next Last Man Standing, Vanessa's having a midlife crisis.
How old do I look?
25.
I'll be serious.
45.
Not that serious.
35. 17. Please make this stop.
But she's got the perfect solution.
Let's have a baby.
What?
Do you remember when I was a new mother? I was so vibrant.
No. You were sleep deprived. You were crazy.
My boobs were giant.
We could talk about it, kid.
Last Man Standing.
This afternoon, starting at 4 on Fox 22.
Welcome back, everyone. According to reported statistics by Maine law enforcement agencies, there are nearly 300 openings statewide in Maine police departments. And leaders tell us they aren't getting nearly the volume of applicants that they used to.
So how do you boost your ranks and then help them stay? That's what's ahead in this installment of Law Enforcement Town Hall.
You know, I just felt like we really had to retool and think outside the box.
Belfast Police Chief Robert Cormier took the helm back in May and says he spent the first few months there working to fill the half dozen openings in the department.
And maybe recruit the way private industry recruits, you know, heavy on social media, sites like Indeed.
He, along with other leaders, say it takes a broader approach to get it done.
We just really run on an open recruitment basis. We take applications whenever we get them, and we start those folks into our application process, at least getting them up through the background investigation so that we know if it's somebody who potentially has maybe an option for us if we have a vacancy.
Cormier and other department leaders also say more recent hiring processes have made clear that today's candidates are different, and a shift in mindset when approaching them is key.
Really, they're doing their homework now. They're looking at our social media sites, you know, Instagram, Facebook. They're looking at our website. They're doing their homework about the city and the community.
One of the people we have in the academy now was a bank manager in their last job and decided, well, I better do it now because this is the age.
They also realize that attracting potential recruits is about more than just selling them on the position itself, especially when they're making a big geographic jump to come here.
You're not just attracting the officer, you're attracting their family. And, you know, is the community that you're a police officer going to be a good fit for them and their family.
But with so many open positions, competition can be fierce. So leaders have fought for higher wages and other financial incentives. They also know if you don't want to get stuck in a revolving door of recruitment, you have to work to keep your officers.
one of the things you've got to push is the work-life balance, that the generation that's coming on, that's what they're looking for.
We now have competitive pay. We have good time off. We have very good benefits.
The folks that we have, because they're our, you know, they're our best salespeople, right? They're the ones who are going to be out there. They're the ones who are going to be able to recruit folks to come and work for us.
At the end of the day, like most careers, it's about fulfillment and the knowledge that the work you do has an impact. It's a message they pass on whenever they can.
We make a difference every day. We try to do the right thing every single day.
So what do you say to would-be hires about coming into law enforcement and that it's still a worthy career?
You make a difference every day when you don't even realize that. I said that one, you know, arrest you make for an OUI, you could be saving a child's life down the road. I said that's how important this stuff is, public safety.
All right. Well, there could soon be another place for people to smoke marijuana in Maine. A bill being considered by the legislature would let people consume recreational marijuana or products right in the store. If this bill passes, stores that wanted to do this would have to have a separate section for on-site consumption. Current law allows for cannabis use on private property, and businesses are not included. Supporters say that's too restrictive and has led to people smoking outside where it bothers other people. If the bill is passed as is, stores that would want to do this would have to get approval from their municipality and the state.
A local school district is getting some new wheels. AOS 91 is adding a new electric bus to its fleet for the Pemetic and Middle and Elementary Schools. It was made possible through the EPA Clean School Bus Program. The Mount Desert School District will receive its third electric bus by the middle of April. Operations Manager Eric Hand says he's excited about the announcement because of how great the other buses have performed so far.
Three things that we like on the electric bus for Lion is the stairs. They actually have an extra step. And the other one is they have composite all the way around because of our environment with sand, salt. So that helps from getting rust. Also, the staircase is the same way. Also, down the aisles are a little bigger. So when you go down, it's much more room for the students to walk down.
Well, Ann says he hopes to acquire at least four more electric school buses for the system in the near future.
A Maine author is expanding her collection of work. Amy Morin is a therapist and the international best-selling author of 13 Things Mentally Strong People Don't Do. This Dexter native splits her time between Florida and Maine. And this year, she's published the 13 Things Mentally Strong People Don't Do workbook to go along with her self-help book of the same name.
Exercises to build mental strength haven't changed, but the world has changed. So it felt like it was finally time to say, yeah, let's make this workbook and really help people figure out how do I build mental strength and apply these things to my life.
Morin says this workbook is not a substitute for therapy, but a tool that can be used in addition to therapy or by individuals who would not seek treatment otherwise. Morin's book is available online.
All right, well, the time now is 8:18. Coming up after the break, we'll take a national look at how the severe weather is affecting different parts of the country in different ways.
Plus your local full weather forecast, this and more when we return.
Here at the Eddington Store, we have what you're craving. From Holton and Dairy Farm products to our daily breakfast, lunch, and dinner specials. Did I mention we have fresh cut meat? From hamburger to steaks and even fresh produce, we have what you're craving. And while you're here, don't forget your ice cream at the Dairy Bar and homemade whoopie pies. Are you low on fuel? We offer gas, diesel, and propane too. The Eddington Store, for more than your average convenience store. We look forward to seeing you.
Come bowl a few games here at Bangor Brewer Bowling Lanes. We're one of the only Candlepin Bowling Alley Centers in Maine, conveniently located in the heart of Brewer. You always have the opportunity to simply bowl for fun. However, you can also join a league. We have youth leagues, adult and senior leagues. Now don't forget, we also host birthday parties for under $100, and gift certificates are also available. Give us a call right away at 989-3798 to make reservations for your birthday party today.
Are you looking to have some fun, including soaring on Skyrider, the ultimate indoor zip line? Well, come over to Urban Air, Bangor's number one birthday party destination, located at the Airport Mall. Urban Air has gravity-defying attractions for all ages, including our warrior course, trampolines, enormous arcade section, and climbing walls. Call us today to schedule your birthday party. And don't forget, we have endless play memberships available as well. Urban Air,
Let them fly.
Finding the right vehicle for you and your family can be a daunting task. At Varney Buick GMC, our expert staff is here to make the journey as painless as possible. Our goal is to get you and your family in a vehicle that will best fit into your lifestyle. Communication is key, and our team makes sure to be completely transparent throughout the process, informing you on all of your options. Come experience Varney Value, only at Varney Buick GMC.
Now to those two major storms bearing down on either side of the country right now. We sound like a broken record, but California is about to get hit again with flooding rains and winds up to 60 miles per hour.
Boy, meanwhile, in the east, a major late season nor'easter could dump feet of snow and cause widespread power outages. ABC's Rhiannon Alley has the latest.
It's exactly what they don't need. More rain in Northern California, up to 6 inches more. On top of already saturated ground. Overnight, evacuation warnings issued in Santa Cruz County.
I want to cry, but what's crying going to do, you know? It's just sad.
In Monterey County, nearly 2,000 people already evacuated when a levee failed in the last storm. Some may not be able to return for weeks. Others didn't get out in time.
My neighbor's there. He's like 80-something years old, has no water. Trying to get water to him. They won't even let us take him water.
In this community of farm workers and immigrants, many had little to begin with.
The damage to their homes and their vehicles and their businesses is going to be severe, and the pain is going to be prolonged for many weeks and months.
Farm losses already estimated at $330 million.
Crews taking advantage of dry weather by working on that levee breach, trying to stabilize it before this next atmospheric river rolls in during the day on Tuesday. More heavy rain in a very saturated state. It's going to be difficult managing the added water, to say the least.
On the other side of the country, a nor'easter taking aim this morning could dump 30 inches of snow in interior New York State and New England. New York's governor mobilizing the National Guard. The biggest worry? High winds and power outages. Some 8,000 utility workers already on standby. Coastal flooding also a concern.
Rhiannon Alley reporting. Now, the storm on the East Coast obviously is the one that's going to impact Maine. We're not expecting 30 inches of snow here,
right.
but we could get several here. I think they're saying like 4 to 8, 4 to 10 inches here in the Bangor area.
Right.
It's already snowing down in southern Maine and in some areas west to us. So it's just a matter of time before it gets here. Hopefully it's an easy breezy storm, as they say, and gets out of here pretty quick.
Yeah, and for now, Devin Biggs has all the details.
Alrighty, Craig and Emma, thank you very much. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Crosby Sports Shop, with a large supply of ammo in stock, custom Damascus knives, fishing supplies of all kinds, concealed weapons classes, and a full line of Dragonfly UV tackle, plus the latest in ultraviolet tackle. Call today. All right, let's get things rolling out there this morning. Some alerts in effect, a winter storm warning, and a winter weather advisory both posted until about 8 a.m. for significant accumulating snow and travel issues at times, too. That'll make things very tough in a few spots. We're watching all of this right here. That'll last until 8 a.m. as we head towards New Wednesday. So travel will be an issue later today and lasting through Wednesday morning. On top of that, closer toward the shoreline, though, winds will be an issue as well. We have storm warnings posted until 1 a.m. along the coastline right about in here. And along some of the coastlines right about in there where the islands are, at least until 8 p.m. Wednesday, gale warnings also posted. Here's the wave heights right now at around 8 to 10 feet, according to the buoys out there. I'm sure we'll see significant increases in the wave heights according to this map, especially as that area low pressure, that nor'easter, continues to track in. But here's a look at things right now. So we're watching the precipitation that's developing, and it's not moving in very quickly. The system is slow to move. We're watching it moving in from the west, going toward the east very slowly. It's going to kind of maneuver and kind of linger around for just a while. But once it starts to move out of here, we'll soon be done with this system. Let's zoom things out and give you the bigger picture. Here's a nor'easter right about in there. It's going to move to the north and east and kind of make a little bit of a loop before it starts to track away from us. Some uncertainty in the forecast still could significantly change some of the snow totals, but we will see some kind of snow before we're all finished up. Let's break this all down with future casts. Increasing wind and chances for snow arriving this afternoon, by about 3 o'clock or so. We'll keep that snow rolling. And then we'll be watching for the snow again as we head towards Wednesday, but not as widespread. There'll be some breaks of that as well, but blowing snow will be possible in a few areas as that area low pressure moves away from us. By Wednesday night, a lot of the snow will start to taper off. And by Thursday, a mixture of clouds and sun could be the possibility, so things will start to look a little bit calmer. Here's the general idea, though. Maybe land around 4 to 8 inches in a few spots before we're all finished up here, but from Bangor off towards the north and east. And then further off towards the south and west, higher totals at around 9 to 10 inches possible, and maybe some higher totals off towards the north as well. So we'll need to keep an eye on this as it does develop a decent snowfall on the way for us. So your forecast for today, mid-30s, mostly cloudy, some afternoon snow, northeast wind gusting up to about 35 miles per hour. By tonight, 30 degrees, snow and blowing snow on the way, the northeast wind gusting up to around 40 miles per hour at times. For tomorrow, upper 30s, snow showers and blowing snow again, the north wind getting up to about 30 miles per hour. Alrighty, here's a look at your extended forecast brought to you by Crosby Sports Shop. Thursday, partly cloudy, highs in the lower 40s. Rain and snow showers back in the forecast on Friday with highs in the lower 40s. That's also St. Patrick's Day. By Saturday, rain and snow showers again, highs in the lower 40s.
Bath Fitter is a better way to remodel your tub. Precise measuring means the perfect fit. The Bath Fitter tub over tub process means no mess or stress. A custom-made tub and seamless wall mean a watertight fit. Premium acrylic means it lasts a lifetime. And all this together means a great value. Bath Fitter, it just fits. Visit bathfitter.com to book your free consultation.
Are you considering buying a new home? A home inspection is a major step in the home buying process. Knowing the current condition of your future home is very important. From simple DIY repairs to major issues that could cost thousands down the road. Not only can TJ inspect your property, but he is also a licensed contractor. Give him a call today at 210-5000 for a free inspection quote.
No matter what type of dog you have or cat you have, Frontline Plus lets you take them everywhere, no matter how you define it. Frontline, the number one name in flea and tick protection.
Here at Twin City Tire and Service, you will be working with industry professionals. We have ASE certified master technicians and certified tire and lube technicians. If we need your vehicle for a duration of time, we offer a complimentary shuttle service and can even offer a loaner vehicle. Being a client at Twin City Tire and Service means that we will treat you right. This includes a 3-year, 36,000-mile warranty on mechanical repairs. We also provide you with 1 year of complimentary roadside assistance. Come see us today at Twin City Tire and Service in Brewer.
When Watch Me Shine wants to know the local forecast, they log on to foxbangor.com. Watch Me Shine is hiring early childhood providers and behavioral health professionals to work with young children and empower them to learn and shine in all they do. To apply, call 990-0162.
President Biden says the American banking system is safe and those who relied on the two banks, which recently went under, will be protected. His assurances, however, aren't calming all fears that more banks could be on the brink of collapse. Fox's Lauren Blanchard is in Washington with more.
Exactly what happens over the next 12, 24, 48 hours is, we're not sure how this is all going to play out.
A choppy day on Wall Street and uncertainty for many small businesses and startup companies after the collapse of two major banks in the last 3 days. President Biden has tried to reassure Americans his administration is handling it.
Americans can rest assured that our banking system is safe. Your deposits are safe.
Silicon Valley Bank and Signature Bank have been taken over by regulators. Other smaller banks are being closely watched to avoid a similar collapse. There was panic that depositors would not be able to access their funds over the insured maximum of $250,000. But after emergency moves by the Treasury, the funds have been made available Monday. Unlike the 2008 bank bailout, President Biden says this one is not pulling from taxpayer money.
No losses will be borne by the taxpayers. Instead, the money will come from the fees that banks pay into the deposit insurance fund.
The president also promised there would be an investigation into what caused the second and third largest bank failures in U.S. history.
My understanding is this bank was making longer-term investments
and wasn't ready for the spike in interest rates caused by the Fed raising discount rate.
The FDIC is transferring all the deposits and assets of Silicon Valley and Signature Banks to a new FDIC-operated bridge bank. In Washington, Lauren Blanchard, Fox News.
Meanwhile, this will be great news for a lot of people. The first ever nasal spray to treat migraines was just approved by the Food and Drug Administration. Pfizer's Savpret can relieve users of pain in as fast as 15 minutes. According to the Migraine Research Foundation, almost 40 million Americans suffer from migraines. Psychiatrists say this drug won't cause medication overuse headache, and it's safe for migraine sufferers with cardiovascular risk factors. Pfizer plans to make that spray available to buy in July.
No retreat or surrender in sight for Russia or Ukraine in the eastern Ukrainian city of Bakhmut. The fight to capture the city has become one of the longest battles in the war, leading to heavy losses on both sides. Fox News chief international correspondent Steve Harrigan has the story.
Russia's effort to capture the eastern Ukrainian city of Bakhmut appears to have stalled, despite continued ground attacks from the Moscow-backed Wagner Group. A Washington-based think tank believes there is no evidence Russian forces are close to victory. On Sunday, the head of the Wagner Group even admitted the situation on the ground was extremely difficult. Ukraine's president also saying more than 1,000 Russian fighters have been killed in Bakhmut over the past week. Some 1,500 others have been wounded and are out of action.
These are wounds incompatible with continuing fighting.
The Russians, for their part, claim to have killed more than 200 Ukrainian soldiers in just a 24-hour period. Those numbers cannot be verified. While the battle rages, Ukraine gets ready for a spring offensive. On Monday, dozens of Ukrainian soldiers wrapped up 4 weeks of training in Spain to learn how to operate the Leopard 2 battle tanks. Spain has promised to deliver six of those tanks to Kyiv in the coming months.
Together with the motivation that the crew brought and the desire to learn, we see them very well prepared to join the combat again.
Also on Monday, UN officials continued their efforts to renew the Black Sea grain deal, which is set to expire Saturday. Talks with a Russian delegation in Geneva ended with Moscow agreeing to the deal's extension, but only for 60 days. The deal allows Ukraine to export grain from its Black Sea ports and also allows Russia to export food and fertilizer. Ukraine has already agreed to the deal's renewal. In Kyiv, Steve Harrigan, Fox News.
Still to come here on the second half of our show, a local library is changing the way that we wait on hold over the phone.
We'll have that story and more as Good Morning Maine continues.
We first opened for business 75 years ago. Between our customers and our staff, we're like family here. I'm worried about this push by Pine Tree Power. It's a government takeover of our electric grid. And it's going to cost about $13.5 billion. That could mean higher taxes or cuts to critical services we rely on. Us Mainers can't afford a risk like that. So next time you hear about Pine Tree Power, ask yourself, who's picking up the tab?
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. You know it didn't come to play. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now's the time to get in and get away. Lease an all-wheel drive Tucson for $249 a month, including $500 lease bonus cash. See your Bangor Hyundai dealer.
You're watching Fox 22 Bangor.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. Today is Tuesday, March 14th, 2023. It's also Pi Day, a day celebrated by mathematicians around the world. Pi is a constant value used in math that represents the ratio of circumference of a circle to its diameter. And I took me a second. I figured it out earlier. It's 314 today. That must be
which
why
are the first
it's
three numbers in pi.
Right.
It's also Albert Einstein's birthday, as we'll see a little later on. So that kind of contributed to it, too.
Which is cool.
Yeah.
And it's also Bake a Pie in Solidarity Day, which encourages people to bake pies to share with the people around them. I like the idea in general of baking pies in solidarity of a lot of things.
Right, right. Yeah, more pie the better, as far as I'm concerned.
It's a good action of solidarity.
Yeah. If you bake a pie and share it with people, then you're spreading goodness everywhere.
And I would like to be included on that.
Right. All right. On this day in history, in 1794, Eli Whitney received a patent for his cotton gin, an invention that revolutionized America's cotton industry. In 1931, a New York City theater became the first to project a movie from the back of the room. A lot of people don't realize that. Well, I guess if you think about it, back in silent movies, they'd have the projector up in the middle or up near the front. And then they figured, let's put it in the back. It won't be as big of a distraction.
You know, I'm just realizing at this very moment, when have you seen footage of a movie theater that's not in a movie? We rarely see footage of that.
That's true. Cool,
from history.
Yeah. I'll keep my eyes open for that now. I'm trying to think. Have I seen that?
Yeah.
In 1967, President John F. Kennedy's body was moved from a temporary grave to its final resting place at Arlington National Cemetery. And in 1995, astronaut Norman Thagard became the first American to enter space aboard a Russian rocket. He joined two cosmonauts as they blasted off for the Mir space station.
Kind of crazy thinking about that, because that was crazy for the time, and now it's unimaginable to us again.
Right.
So
now we depend on each other for it.
So. Right. Yeah. Right. All right. Birthdays today include actor Billy Crystal, who's 74. Music producer Quincy Jones is 89. Basketball star Steph Curry is 34. Olympic gold medal gymnast Simone Biles is 24. I did not realize she was that young.
Yeah.
Very cool. And, of course, it's also the birthday of physicist Albert Einstein, who was born in Germany in 1879.
One of the most famous ones of all.
Right.
All right. We've been talking about it all hour. We've got a big storm that's moving into the state right now, bringing a bunch of snow. So for the latest on that, let's turn things over to Devin.
And thank you very much, Craig and Emma. Happy Tuesday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Crosby Sports Shop. With a large supply of ammo in stock, custom Damascus knives, fishing supplies of all kinds, concealed weapons classes, and a full line of Dragonfly UV tackle, plus the latest in ultraviolet tackle. Call today. All right, let's get things rolling out there this morning. We have weather alerts in effect. This right here is a winter storm warning in effect, and also a winter weather advisory posted. It's all toward the north. Both of these will last until Wednesday morning at about 8 a.m. as we'll be watching for accumulating snow across the region. On top of that, some strong winds that will cause the ocean to really get active at times, which is why we have gale warnings and storm warnings also posted. Some of these expiring at 1 a.m. Wednesday, others expiring later at 8 p.m. as we head towards your Wednesday as well. So we'll need to be careful with that as it does develop. We're watching it moving in from the west, going toward the east very slowly. A nor'easter on the way, though. That'll bring us some significant snow to a few spots, along with winds up to 40 miles per hour, if not worse than a few spots. We'll zoom things out. Here's the system right now, slowly tracking off towards the north and east. It's going to kind of move around for a bit before it starts to move away from us as we do proceed forward. So futurecast for today, the system starts moving during the afternoon period. There's a snow right there. But again, starting to back off a little bit as we head towards Wednesday morning. That snow will continue from time to time as well. Your hourly forecast moving forward. Here we are. We're watching for the snow moving in during the afternoon period. Temperatures in the 30s. Your full five-day forecast is coming up. Craig and Emma.
Thank you, Devin. Well, few things are more frustrating than calling a business and getting an automated machine when you really want to talk to an actual person on the line. However, the Sears Port Library has found a really fun way to make being put on hold a little more enjoyable. Our Jody Hersey recently dialed in and has more.
Carver Memorial Library is closed today.
All too often, we call a store, a library, hospital, or other business, hoping to speak to a person and not a machine. But the automated system at the Carver Memorial Library in Searsport is unlike any you've experienced before. Just listen.
For a song, press 4. For a poem, press 5. For a joke, press 6.
What's the unhappiest day of the week? Saturday.
Library Director Sue McGlintock says she's heard all kinds of reactions to the library's phone system.
But honestly, I would say it's mostly vendors who comment on the messages rather than the public.
which has been interesting. So it makes all of the service people's day because they have to spend all this time calling. And they're like, I just have to say, I love your phone menu.
Rhonda Nichols works at the library's front desk and has also received lots of feedback.
Have had families say that they call in and listen at different times.
According to McGlintock, the library's automated system is not that high tech.
And so this is actually built just on a regular business phone answering machine system. It's what we get from our phone company. They call it an auto attendant. I've had a number of people say, oh, I'm going to have to call back and like press more of the numbers.
Library staff record the song, poem, joke, and fun fact themselves, changing it just 3 to 4 times a year.
I'm in the mood for singing. Hey, how about you?
The staff says it hopes this service will encourage more in the community to stop by or even give the library a ring. In Searsport, I'm Jody Hersey for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Isn't that neat? Maybe we can get some of the people around here to sing on our answering machine for people.
They had jokes and singing. Yeah.
Right.
I think they're starting a movement. Or at least I would like to see that.
I like it.
Yeah. All right. Well, still to come here this morning, Tyler Cruz will have those sports updates.
We'll be right back.
If you're eligible for Medicare and Medicaid, a Medicare Advantage plan from Anthem MaineHealth can come with all the benefits you want and zero compromises. Just go to anthemmainehealth.com/answers or call 855-753-3928 for a one-on-one Medicare plan review. Ask about our $0 monthly premium plans that include dental, vision, and hearing coverage, along with transportation, a free gym membership, and $0 copay for prescriptions, all for zero extra cost. Plus, you could be eligible for extra benefits to help you save even more. We have plans with up to $2,500 a year to help you pay for over-the-counter health items, groceries, and living expenses like cell phone, electric, or water bills, all on a single prepaid MasterCard you can use at thousands of locations nationwide. Call Anthem MaineHealth at 855-753-3928 or visit anthemmainehealth.com/answers and get a Medicare Advantage plan with zero compromises for you and your wallet.
Markdown Madness has started at the Furniture Gallery, and we're in the game to save you money. Introducing our starting lineup, 10% off all in-stock recliners for the best seat in the house. 10% off all adjustable bases to upgrade your sleep and be game day ready. And up to 70% off all clearance items. The Furniture Gallery brings you better brand names plus a bigger in-stock selection, all at the lowest prices around. Hurry in to catch all the action. Find your best value at the Furniture Gallery in Augusta, Bangor, Gorham, Newport, and North Windham.
I'm gonna make this right.
You can tell me the truth.
Accused, tonight on Fox.
Welcome back in, everyone. Thank you for staying with us. Let's start things off on the ice. Maine hockey season didn't end the way they wanted it with a loss to Vermont in the play-in round last week, but a lot of good things going on there, and that is highlighted by the end-of-the-year awards. Junior forward Lyndon Breen, who finished second in program history with 21 goals this season, was named second team All-Hockey East. Joining him on that squad, junior goalie Victor Ostman. And then to cap it all off, Hockey East named their three finalists for the Bob Cullen Coach of the Year Award earlier on Monday, with Maine's second-year head coach Ben Barr being one of those three. Barr's Black Bears were picked to finish last in the conference preseason, and they wound up in the top half of Hockey East at 6 to be exact, and all signs point to more improvement in the coming seasons. Let's stay on the Black Bears now, and we will go over to the Diamond, where softball is in action. It's a Monday evening game out in Fresno, California. Looks like it with the sunshine there. Black Bears taking on the Bulldogs. Top second, Katie Jo Mori drives this one past the first baseman. That's going to get mishandled a little bit by the right fielder, and that puts runners on second and third, and that will set the table for Nora Campo. She blasts this ball to deep center straight away, and that baby is gone. That's going to make it a 3-run lead. Black Bears on top early. To the bottom of the seventh we go. Maine up 3-1. Taran Aragoyan gets a hold of this one. That's going to find a gap. That's going to make it 3-2. She is in scoring position, would later score on a triple by Abby Dowdy. That would tie it. So Kat Fallon trying to save it and send it to extras, but the ball is going to get by right here. That's going to bring in the winning run in Dowdy, and Fresno State walks off on Maine 4-3 is the final. All right, let's go to the court now. The high school hoop season in Maine officially wrapped up with the state championships last week and unofficially ended on Saturday night. For the second year in a row, over in VZ, Big Time Hoops Maine hosted their annual All-Star Weekend. It started Friday night with a Rising Stars game and then followed on Saturday with several events. There was a dunk contest, a skills competition, three-point contest, all capped off by the girls and boys All-Star games. And talking to some of those athletes on Saturday, having that collection of talent all in the same building, playing with and against each other, was something special.
It's really fun. It's really fun being around like all the teammates or teams that we've played throughout the years and getting to actually play with them.
Oh yeah, it's way different. I mean, it's more basketball than all of us. You know, we're all really close friends off the court. On the court, it's a little bit more competitive, but you know, we love each other either way.
Awesome, man. It all comes down to the kids. Like, we couldn't do it if the kids didn't buy into it. They've been down and supported big time with whatever we've done over the course of the couple years here. So just having their buy-in, having them here, I mean, you see the talent on display and what we've done so far tonight, it's awesome.
Collection of Maine's best basketball talent wouldn't be complete without a blast from the past. Annie Bedard and Nick Cantor Medley both showed up to coach, and the dunk contest featured two of 2022's brightest stars, Tennessee commit JP Estrella made an appearance, as well as Newport's own Cooper Flagg, and Ace was in attendance as well.
I mean, it feels great just being home, seeing all my friends and stuff, and just being able to come out and entertain people from my community. So just love being able to put on a show, and that's what me and JP just came here to do.
It was great to be back. You know, it's home. Born and raised here, so it's always great to be back. You know, great to see all the main talent, girls and boys side, seeing all the guys coming back, like me and Coop, Ace, all of them.
I look like fun there. Let's go to some football now. I know we're only halfway through March, so there is quite some time before we're on the gridiron. But on Monday, the NFL season unofficially began with the legal tampering period at the head of the official start of free agency on Wednesday. For starters, a huge piece of New England's defense came back to Foxborough. Jonathan Jones is staying with the Patriots. He was set to hit the open market, but will stay in New England for the tune of 2 years and $19 million, $13 million of that guaranteed. And then in a move to free up some cap space, it's tight end Jonnu Smith who is on the move. Smith will head to Atlanta for a seventh-round pick. That's kind of a bust of a free agent signing there. Ahead of 2021, we signed him for a four-year, $50 million deal with the Pats. New England is also bringing back defensive tackle Carl Davis. They agreed to a one-year deal with him. He played in all 16 games with 11 total tackles and one sack. All right, staying down there and going back to the ice, the Bruins are on a roll this season, and over the weekend, they officially clinched a playoff spot. Bruins became one of the fastest team to 50 wins late last week. And then with three unanswered goals and part of a comeback win on Saturday, you can officially put an X next to their name in the standings because they clinched their spot in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Right now, the Bees are by far the best team in the league statistically with 50 wins and 105 points. Next best team has 43 and 94. So Boston will likely win the President's Cup as well and the number one seed in the East. Captain Patrice Bergeron says the depth and the chemistry of this team has been a major key.
It's been fun. It's a great team chemistry as well. I think guys stick together, but obviously that depth is something you want to rely on, and everyone can contribute. You want to make sure everyone is valued.
Not that there was any doubt, but you formally clinched the playoff spot. Do you even address that at this point, or you just shrug and move on? What do you do?
Shrug and move on. Yeah, I think we knew at Thanksgiving we were making the playoffs, right?
I kind of did too. That's all the time we have for sports. We'll be right back after the break.
Electrify Maine is Maine's number one electrical contractor, providing outstanding electrical services to businesses, industries, and homes throughout the state. Electrify Maine also sells and installs heat pumps and is a licensed Generac dealer. Call us today for a free estimate.
They've got the sharpest pencil in town. Now they just sit around that showroom, figuring deals and whittling that old pencil down. They know that if you buy once, you're gonna be back. So instead of buying one, you're buying two, and that's a fact. They've got the sharpest pencil in town.
So come on down, neighbor. The coffee pot's on.
I went to Angie and typed in pool,
water heater,
cleaners, garage,
interior painting, exterior painting.
For whatever project you need, there's an option.
Ooh, I have another project. Let me try this.
Get started at Angie.com today.
Imagine yourself in a new Toyota.
Yeah.
Sick.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Right now, you could save up to $1,400 with affordable 3.99% financing on a luxurious Highlander. And every Highlander comes with 2 years no-cost maintenance and more.
Ready, set, go get your Toyota today.
Toyota. Let's go places.
Electrify Maine is Maine's number one electrical contractor, providing outstanding electrical services to businesses, industries, and homes throughout the state. Electrify Maine also sells and installs heat pumps and is a licensed Generac dealer. Call us today for a free estimate.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. Well, Disney's CEO talks pricing at theme parks. Pfizer will increase its cancer drug portfolio, and Mediterranean diets could lower the risk of Alzheimer's.
Fox's Tanya Powers has today's business briefs.
Sorry, I didn't mean to step on your toes. Sorry.
Walt Disney CEO Bob Iger says his company may have been too aggressive with price increases at Disney theme parks. Iger spoke last week at a conference hosted by Morgan Stanley. He said Disney may have been too aggressive with its pricing, quote, in our zeal to grow profits. Iger also says there are ways to grow the theme park's business but be smarter about pricing so Disney can, as Iger put it, maintain that brand value of accessibility. Pfizer will pay around $43 billion to purchase cancer drug manufacturer Seagen. Pfizer's portfolio already includes 24 drugs approved to fight cancer. The purchase will add four more cancer drugs to that portfolio. Seagen specializes in antibody drug conjugates, treatment designed to target cancer while sparing healthy cells. And a recent study finds that people who maintain the Mediterranean and Mediterranean-based diets could be at a lower risk for developing Alzheimer's disease. Researchers at Rush University in Chicago analyzed the autopsy results of people who had provided their complete dietary information at the start of the study. The researchers found that people who followed a Mediterranean diet had fewer signs of Alzheimer's in their brain tissue. The study's lead author says there are some limitations to the findings. Most participants were white, non-Hispanic, and older, so the results can't be extended to other populations. That's business. I'm Tanya J. Powers.
All right, well, switching gears now, Devin Biggs is going to have our full forecast with all that snow.
All righty, Craig and Emma, thank you very much. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Crosby Sports Shop. With a large supply of ammo in stock, custom Damascus knives, fishing supplies of all kinds, concealed weapons classes, and a full line of Dragonfly UV tackle, plus the latest in ultraviolet tackle. Call today. All right, let's get things rolling out there this morning. Some alerts in effect, a winter storm warning, and a winter weather advisory both posted until about 8 a.m. for significant accumulating snow and travel issues at times, too. That'll make things very tough in a few spots. We're watching all of this right here. That'll last until 8 a.m. as we head towards your Wednesday. So travel will be an issue later today and lasting through Wednesday morning. On top of that, closer toward the shoreline, though, winds will be an issue as well. We have storm warnings posted until 1 a.m. along the coastline right about in here. And along some of the coastlines right about near where the islands are, at least until 8 p.m. Wednesday, gale warnings also posted. Here's the wave heights right now at around 8 to 10 feet, according to the buoys out there. I'm sure we'll see significant increases in the wave heights according to this map, especially as that area of low pressure, that nor'easter, continues to track in. But here's a look at things right now. So we're watching the precipitation that's developing, and it's not moving in very quickly. The system is slow to move. We're watching it moving in from the west, going toward the east very slowly. It's going to kind of maneuver and kind of linger around for just a while, but once it starts to move out of here, we'll soon be done with this system. Let's zoom things out and give you the bigger picture. Here's the nor'easter right about in there. It's going to move to the north and east and kind of make a little bit of a loop before it starts to track away from us. Some uncertainty in the forecast still could significantly change some of the snow totals, but we will see some kind of snow before we're all finished up. Let's break this all down with Futurecast. Increasing wind and chances for snow arriving this afternoon by about 3 o'clock or so. We'll keep that snow rolling. And then we'll be watching for the snow again as we head towards Wednesday, but not as widespread. There'll be some breaks for that as well, but blowing snow will be possible in a few areas as that area low pressure moves away from us. By Wednesday night, a lot of the snow will start to taper off. And by Thursday, a mixture of clouds and sun could be the possibility, so things will start to look a little bit calmer. Here's the general idea, though. Maybe that around 4 to 8 inches in a few spots before we're all finished up here, but from Bangor off towards the north and east. Then further off towards the south and west, higher totals at around 9 to 10 inches possible, and maybe some higher totals off towards the north as well. So we'll need to keep an eye on this as it does develop a decent snowfall on the way for us. So your forecast for today, mid-30s, mostly cloudy, some afternoon snow, northeast wind gusting up to about 35 miles per hour. By tonight, 30 degrees, snow and blowing snow on the way, the northeast wind gusting up to around 40 miles per hour at times. For tomorrow, upper 30s, snow showers and blowing snow again, the north wind getting up to about 30 miles per hour. Alrighty, here's a look at your extended forecast brought to you by Crosby Sports Shop. Thursday, partly cloudy, highs in the lower 40s. Rain and snow showers back in the forecast on Friday with highs in the lower 40s. That's also St. Patrick's Day. By Saturday, rain and snow showers again, highs in the lower 40s.
Looking to buy or sell a home? The More True team of Better Homes and Gardens works throughout the state of Maine with both buyers and sellers with a focus on the greater Bangor area. Give the ladies of the More True team a call today or visit their Facebook page.
Sometimes big truck accidents can result in big case settlements. These are just some of the big case results I fought to get my clients. If a big truck hurts you, we'll make them pay you every single dollar you deserve for your injuries. I'm Jim with Lowry & Associates. If you've been hurt by a big truck, call the twos. We win for you.
Hurt by a big truck? Come out on top. Call the twos. Call 222-2222.
Family owned and operating in the Bangor area for more than 10 years, Crosby's Welding is here to help you. We specialize in steel, stainless steel, and aluminum welding and fabrication. We serve many of the local industries from Maine lobstermen to the commercial trucking industry and everything in between. Fully mobile on-site construction services right down to custom signs and fire pits. Fast, friendly, reliable service. Give us a call today for a free estimate, 974-7815.
Bath remodeling was revolutionized in this garage in 1984 when three brothers created the iconic Bath Fitter tub-over-tub process. A breakthrough then, the industry standard now for beautiful baths without the mess, stress, or high cost. A better way from Bath Fitter means precise measurement, the highest quality acrylic, perfect preparation, and watertight installation backed by a lifetime warranty. Bath Fitter, it just fits. Visit bathfitter.com to book your free consultation.
Looking to buy or sell a home? The More True team of Better Homes and Gardens works throughout the state of Maine with both buyers and sellers with a focus on the greater Bangor area. Give the ladies of the More True team a call today or visit their Facebook page.
All right, take a look at this. This owl decides to skip the flight and journey south on a cruise ship instead. The endangered burrowing owl was spotted on the Symphony of the Seas cruise ship. It made itself at home, seen by fellow guests perching atop the exit signs, railings, and peeking out from planters. A biologist was brought on board with the task of wrangling the little bird during a short window of time before guests began boarding. Ultimately, though, the owl was caught and taken to the South Florida Wildlife Center for a wellness check.
Aww.
In the meantime, it looks like it had a little fun. Awful cute.
He kind of got whacked a little bit on accident. All right. Okay, one more story to end the day. Archaeologists count on sheep to preserve a historic site in Italy. Sheep are grazing on the grass around Pompeii to protect ancient ruins in a sustainable and cost-effective way. About 150 sheep feed on grass near the Roman archaeological site to help restrict growth of weeds and naturally fertilize the soil. The environmentally friendly 9-month project kicked off last November without any cost to park authorities. The director of the site says using ancient techniques and coexisting with the landscape is like going back to our roots. That's so cool. It's symbiotic for whoever has the sheep, and it helps the environment and longevity of that site. Yeah. Very cool.
And people have been doing that for centuries. I know even some municipalities will do that. They'll get a bunch of goats to come in and clear out an area.
That's cool. I should get a bunch of goats and rent them out for people who want that.